All right, thank you all for coming. Okay, I can hardly see because the lights are pretty bright, but please raise your hand if you were here last year. Quite a few of you. Please raise your hand if you've been to any of the conferences that I've run in the past 20 years. All right, so there's a lot of people here who don't quite know what you're about to be in for. So you're going to have a good, damn good time, as Martin just said. I have spent the past 20 or 30 years doing both science and community building in this field. Really, most of the science was at the beginning, and I've spent more of my time on the community building than on the science, really, in the past 15 years or so. And these conferences are the centerpiece, the fulcrum of what I do in this thing. You know, I live for these conferences. My adrenaline is up here right now. I want to pick up on something that Martin said towards the end of his remarks. A lot of people have the, slightly irritating habit of describing me as the founder of this field. But of course, it's not true. Everyone who makes a contribution in any field, they build on the shoulders of people who came before. And one person who came before me is Michael Rose, whose work came to prominence 20 years before anyone knew my name. And actually, some of that work is represented here. I wanted to mention the fact that he said, in probably the 1990s, that at some point we will bring aging under comprehensive medical control, and when we do, we will be deeply ashamed that we didn't do it more quickly. I think that really emphasizes the point that Martin was making just now. Next thing I want to say is, some of you may be a little confused about the organizational structure here. You see it says here, proudly partnered with LEV Foundation. In my world right now, there are really three organizations officially, but spiritually there's one organization. The three organizations are LEV Foundation, which I'm, of course, the president and chief science officer of, and Longevity Events Limited, which is Martin's company that's running this conference and ran it last year as well, of course. And then there's the HealthSpan Action Coalition, which is a very much amplified effort in the advocacy and general audience space. There was a quote from George Bernard Shaw earlier. There's another quote from Shaw that I rather like, which is that the reasonable man adapts himself to his circumstances, whereas the unreasonable man tries to adapt circumstances to his own preferences. Therefore, all progress depends on the unreasonable man. And I'm a pretty damned unreasonable man. I'm not about to stop being so. I wrote an editorial in Rejuvenation Research nearly 20 years ago called Long Live the Unreasonable Man, in which I focused on this. And, we have to actually be proud to be unreasonable in order to get shit done here. Last year, as those of you who were here will remember, I had very recently achieved the position of being able to start a new foundation, which is now LEV Foundation, Longevity Escape Velocity, but which last September didn't even have a name. And I talked a bit about plans, but it was all a bit nebulous back then. Things have moved pretty fast in the meantime. Of course, there is the flagship project of ours, this extremely ambitious and expensive and, I believe, absolutely critical experiment being done at Ichor Life Sciences up in Syracuse, New York. And I won't talk about that now at all because it will be the focus of the first hour of Saturday when both I and Danik Wartell, who is in charge on the ground in Syracuse, will be describing the work we're doing and plan to do in a good deal of detail. That experiment began in February. We bought the mice in December. I gave some of my team extreme palpitations by really forcing the pace there, because I'm a bit of a young man in a hurry. Everything went fine. We have fantastic people getting this work done, so nothing's gone significantly wrong. And I'm delighted that Ichor are here in force, and you'll be here, as I say, you'll be hearing a lot more about that. But in terms of other progress at LEV Foundation, I want to highlight a few people who were not significantly involved back then, but now very much are. I don't know which order to go in. Let's go from the left. So Gennady Stolyarov is now the treasurer of the foundation. David Wood, please stand up, David, is our executive director. David is someone that many of you in this part of the world will know because he has he has run an organization called London Futurists for the past many years and has really excelled organizationally and, you know, in all the ways that endear, that qualify somebody to be the executive director of an organization. And furthermore, he is, fearless enough to be willing to run an organization that has me in it, which is not a trivial thing. And finally, I want to highlight Melissa King, who is the chairman of our board of directors. Please stand up, Melissa. And and in that respect, I want to say a few more words about the HealthSpan Action Coalition. Melissa will be speaking maybe Sunday? Melissa is also the chief operating officer at the HealthSpan Action Coalition, and her joint roles are very much, you know, the glue that highlights how closely the two organizations are working together. I think it's fair to say that, you know, LEV Foundation and HealthSpan Action Coalition and longevity events are spiritually a single organization at this point, and will continue to be so. I haven't got all that much more to say, actually, right now. I think I just want to mention a few more things. First of all, another thing relating to outreach and educating the world, getting the world to be angrier about aging and to be more unreasonable. One thing that I'm expecting to be able to announce at the gala dinner, so I will only say a few words about it now, is that largely thanks to Martin, actually, who led this initiative initially, the great and the good, shall we say, of the biology of aging, the luminaries who are the best known in the field, and most of whom are here during this meeting, are coming together to put together a call to arms, really, a statement of urgency to actually get shit together and start working on aging as a medical problem and start saving some lives. This is something that has been conspicuously and tragically absent from the public pronouncements of pretty much everyone in the biology of aging except me. And so it is a very important new initiative, and I'll say more about that on Saturday evening. The other thing I just want to say is a housekeeping thing, actually a couple of housekeeping things. First of all, to speakers, yes, I know that everyone here is, you know, who's speaking is experienced at this, and you are like very relaxed about, for example, actually as such giving your PowerPoint or your keynote or whatever to the tech people, but please do that, you know, with a good deal of lead time, you know, preferably the previous day before you're speaking, certainly the previous session, but yes, please go for the previous day if you possibly can. And also in terms of speakers, I know that some speakers will prefer not to have their talks recorded, so I invite any speaker who doesn't want their talk to be recorded to say so at the beginning of their talk when they're here on stage so that everybody knows, because it also applies to you guys, the audience. When someone says that, please don't take any photographs or anything like that during such talks. Otherwise, you can basically do what you like, though, I mean, don't use flash or anything stupid like that. And finally, posters. So actually, I don't know exactly where the posters are going to be, but they should be in the bar. Martin, are you still around? Maybe you can, Beatrice? Okay, Martin, shout or get a microphone or come up here or anywhere. Oh, good. All right, so the bar is out here, right? Okay, good. So one thing that those of you who have not been to my meetings need to know, because it's a very important aspect of the networking and socializing aspect of these events, is that the bar is free. every night. It's only free for beer and wine. If you want to drink, you know, high quality whiskey, you've got to pay for that. But that is really the substrate of keeping people hanging around and talking to each other and meeting and collaborating and so on for a bit longer than you otherwise might. So that's something that I learned a long time ago. So please hang out. Obviously, also please go and see the posters. People who are presenting posters, please be there near your posters to describe what you've done and everything for the the first hour or so of the post-dinner session. And that's pretty much all I've got to say. I want you all to enjoy this meeting as much as I'm going to. This is my annual party, as far as I'm concerned. And, please, if you have any questions for me or you just want to chat, grab me whenever you like. That's my style. And I'll just, give a few minutes for everyone to get the first talk of the meeting going. This is one of just a few talks that are going to be presented by video. Michael Levin is one of the real superstar newcomers to this field. He, until very recently, he would not have thought of himself as a longevity researcher, or at least he wouldn't describe himself that way. But he has been embraced very energetically by this community, and you will see that that is for very good reason. So I'll stop there and let everything get going. Thanks very much.